Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for September the 2nd of 2019, well, it is titled The Moon and Jupiter Over the Alps. So what do we see here? Well, in this nicely framed image taken in northern Italy up in the Alps, we can see, of course, the mountains and the Earth in the foreground. That's one planet in the image. But we can also see several others. Now, the brightest object in this is not a planet, but is, of course, our own moon. So this image taken just after sunset would show a crescent moon off in the distance. Now, as you look at that, it's not going to look like a crescent. In fact, it looks quite like a full moon. Well, the full moon cannot be in the west right after sunset because it is going to be opposite to the sun in the sky. So how do we know it is a crescent? Well, because of its positioning, and it doesn't appear to be a crescent because it is vastly overexposed. And that's not a problem. That's just how it has to be done. The moon is so much brighter than the other objects that if we took an image just to look at the moon and to see details on the moon, then we would lose the other objects in this image, especially the objects in the sky that we want to look at. Now, some of those are two other planets that we see here. Just below and to the left of the moon, we do see the planet Jupiter, the largest planet in the solar system. And of course, while it seems much smaller than the moon here, that's simply because the moon is so much closer. If Jupiter were as close as the moon, it would be greatly dominating the moon in terms of size, and of course would cause significant problems for us here on Earth, as its gravity would be significantly larger than the Earth's. So it's only a matter of perspective and the distance at which we see things. We also see up to the upper left-hand side the planet Saturn towards the upper left of the image. That's the great ringed planet, although you cannot see the rings, of course, without a small telescope to be able to bring out that much detail. But Jupiter and Saturn are two of the planets that are easily visible in the sky and now easily visible in the evening sky over the coming months, so a chance to be able to see these planets. There are five planets that are visible to the naked eye. Jupiter and Saturn are two of them. And Mars and Venus are two others that are relatively easy to find at various times. The hardest one to find is Mercury. Mercury, very close to the sun, is very difficult to see unless you catch it right before sunrise or right after sunset, and even then only when it is at its furthest away from the sun. So it's very difficult to see off in the distance there, mainly because it is so close to the sun. And what we see here with Jupiter and the moon is what is called a conjunction. A conjunction is when two astronomical objects happen to be close together in the sky. So the moon and a planet, two planets, or the planet and a bright star are some types of things that could be conjunctions. We can also get occultations. Occultations occur when one object passes in front of another. So if the moon were to pass in front of one of the planets and temporarily block out its light, if a planet were to pass directly in front of a star and block out its light, those would be examples of occultations and are other events that astronomers and astrophotographers like to be able to image. So here we get the nicely framed image of the Alps in the foreground, and of course the moon and two of the distant planets, Jupiter and Saturn, in the sky. So that was our picture of the day for September the 2nd of 2019. It was titled The Moon and Jupiter Over the Alps. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Black Hole versus Neutron Star. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone. And I will see you in class.